So it's about dinner time. So many of the audiences have left. It's okay. So we just follow the schedule. I'm Zeng Shufang from Huawei. Me and my colleague from my Intel, we're going to present this project to you. So I'm going to introduce what we have done. Wang Qing is from the Intel, and he is also the responsible person in Greater China region, and he is going to talk about the conditions of the projects afterwards. So we start with SODA. What is SODA? For me, I think it's a data management platform. No matter it is smart, autonomous, etc., they are all adjectives. Why we need these data management platform? Because based on current conditions, the IT facilities of companies, different types of them, like containers, like from clouds or edge computing, etc. On the south, there are other storage provided by different manufacturers and also provided by cloud producers. In between, we want to connect the north and the south, and in the middle, there are many data management platforms or software, for example, like for VM, for a copy, for monitoring, and also for resource distribution. We want to do this because we want to coordinate and to build a data management platform so that a user can use them easily. So kind of one of the motivations we have. And then about the architecture. So first, with the northbound, there is a plugin, we call it MBP. It's for the interaction with Kubernetes and other traditional application platform. In the middle, the orange part is mainly for traditional data management, for example, like for the module or document distribution, we can mount it, we can apply it, etc. For the purple parts, it's for the intelligent monitoring. We will monitor the information of the device, and based on the information, we can make intelligent predictions. This is newly added here.
And then for the red parts, some basic modules providing
basic functions for other modules. And for the blue part, for the green parts, it is for connecting different storage devices, and the blue parts is for connecting different cloud platforms. In terms of multi-cloud, we have the object storage management. Then we have our project. Sushi is for the northbound project, and then the southbound, and then in between for the multi-cloud project. So just now, we talked about the architecture. Then I have some key functions to share with you to briefly tell you what it is. And first is the data provisioning. We have
creating volumes, mapping,
unloading, loading, etc. We support and on the right part, there is the file sharing and ASL creation. And you can see we support this
and
the
manual,
and also drivers. In addition to basic functions, we have the orchestration. How will orchestration work?
Well,
an example is that we have a machine we want to mount a file.
那我要做什么事情呢?
Then what should we do? We need to create a file and then mount it to get information, and then mount the file. Basically, we have all the functions.
If
for achieving this, it's possible to do it manually, but it's inconvenient. By orchestration, all the basic functions or operations can be arranged into a service.
And then,
when we run into the same scenario, we can run the
service.
And here there is a workflows and actions, because for the backstage, we are using these that stone. But of course, it is plug-in type of service, so we can use different drivers. Actually, the workflow and actions contained here. So if you use the before, you know that the workflow is self-defined with a series of actions in the workflows. After you define it, on the top, we can see the service. When you run the service, we are using the backend to run those series of actions. This is what we say as intelligent data provisioning. On the basis of data service, we have made some intelligent actions. This is the data operation about the purple parts, artificial intelligence monitoring. There is a dock and with some connectors to four different platforms, and we can get information from different platforms. By using the converter function, we can send it to different platforms. For example, we can combine with Prometheus, and Prometheus can combine with Gabbana. Then we can present information visually, and also we can go through Healthpad. We have a basic machine learning module. After getting information from Healthpad, they can make predictions. At the right bottom corner, there is the DB scan. It is the IOPS and the delay prediction.
刚说的这个,
in addition to Prometheus and Kafka, other parties of platforms can be used, but we need corresponding converter exporter. After connecting it, we need to do something else. And sorry about the API. Since we say it is for monitoring data, then API is for providing the interface to trigger the incident from happening.
然后在下面的话是
the data migration. So it's a very simple graph. I'll briefly tell you what it is. In order to migrate data, there is a base. We are now migrating objects for multi-cloud. In such a scenario, the basic requirement is that we want a unified interface so that users can connect to different clouds, like Zero Blob, like Huawei service or other service. After connecting them, user will have an API so that users don't have to worry about the backend. They can go through the unified API. And then we have the migration based on strategy and the life cycle. Such migration is comparatively simple because user can design their plans so that they can decide where the data should go to.
soda,
then the soda will allocate and create such a mission. Then the data can be migrated to designated place.
Another one is complex. It involves different scenarios that is cloud lifecycle. This is for the object. You may have used the object based one. The life cycle is provided by private cloud. After the data is generated, over time, their data heat degrees are declining, then we need to migrate the data to another one. Or after the data is expired, we need to delete it. That is a typical life cycle. For the public cloud, it has its own life cycle management. For example, AWS S3, for example, define the rules of the life cycle. The rules include when to migrate the data and where to migrate the data or when to delete the data. Then the vendor will do the migration or deletion for you. As a public cloud has its own life cycle management, however, they have two issues. Each vendor has different interfaces. So if you use different clouds or multiple clouds, you should be adapted to the interfaces. It's a complex. When we use data now, we have the safety or security requirements to prevent the vendor bounding, so we may use multiple clouds, and the price also is different, so we do not use only one cloud. We use multiple clouds. In this case, we may have the issue that is adaption. The second issue is about data migration. Maybe after 3 decades, I migrate data from a standard storage to another one. Then, maybe after 90 days, I need to delete it. It can only be done within the cloud. Cannot be done cross clouds. So the life cycle can resolve these two issues. We provide the same interface. When user uses it through the SODA interface to define the rules of a life cycle. No matter what the cloud is used at the back end, after setting the rules, the schedule is done by the SODA. Also, without concerning the backend, and it supports cross cloud. The data is on the CF S3, but after a while you want to migrate it to a ADAS, and then archive it to S3 and delete it. Even you can store it on AWS, and after a while others reduce the price, then you can set the rules after how many days it should be deleted. You can do not do that with a public cloud. So this is the life cycle. Migration and life cycle.
It's also noteworthy to
say that they have the different definition of the storage layer. We also have the definition by default, the hot, the warm, and the cold. We can support the users to define. You can add one storage layer and corresponding to the layer of the public cloud. After the definition, we can do the data management for you. This is a data migration. I just selected some of the features to show you. It actually has much more features. If you are interested in them, you can go to the links as shown here to get more details. OpenSDS, you can see my t-shirt is also from OpenSDS. The theme is SODA for this presentation, but maybe in the future we may change the name. This is the contact information. If you are interested in it, you can go to the website to search OpenSDS, then you can get the relevant information. Okay, that's all from my side. Now I give the floor to Mr. Wang Qing to introduce the community. My name is Wang Qing. I'm from Intel. My work is mainly about the network and storage. I don't know how many of you have the background of storage. For the network, at the beginning, we had the concept of SDM. That means if... you buy different the switches from different vendors for networking, then the commands and the interfaces are different and the interconnectivity is not easy. That's why there is a software-defined network, SDN. I think the project is also similar to this. The data is flowing, and in the future we will see more big data. And now I'm also engaged in edge computing. It's not only deployed by one vendor. Actually, it involves different cloud providers and vendors, so the integration communication are very important. In other countries, they have different cloud providers and operators. So for the cloud computing infrastructure service, in the past, you selected the storage model. Maybe you used the private storage and the paid storage, but now you can use open source storage. So there is the issue of legacy of storage. How can you migrate the data from the old storage system to the new system? So the OpenSDS can provide the platform for users to have the unified interface, no matter what the storage is used or no matter what the public cloud it is. This is transparent. This project is the massive project requiring the support from different vendors. For the OpenStack, you may think it's quite similar, but my personal understanding is yes, they are similar, but for OpenStack, it supports the Kubernetes, but they are not only two forms of the cloud, not only two cloud solutions. Different companies, for example, AWS, have different solutions of cloud and DStack. So there are many kinds. If you use different models or different cloud solutions, then the data storage management and the processing have the issue how to do the interconnectivity. So for the OpenSDS project, we want to have a more universal scope, which is named into a SODA program. SODA, the first slide shows you the definition. It's smart and also simple. Data autonomy. We hope we can provide a unified or harmonized storage platform and a data management platform. It means that in the open source storage, there are different solutions to SAP and also some clients. Even in the conference, the colleagues from JD.com introduced their solution. It's the container oriented under the China. And also the China Unicom has the open source solution. So different companies have their own solutions. But for Linux Foundation, it has Linux Snack Working. It's an open source Snack Working opportunity, but there is no this kind of unified platform for storage. That's why we want to establish such a program to be a unified platform and also for integration of different storage systems in an interconnected way to meet the flow and the data flow demand. And for the integration and collaboration, it's very important to have such a platform
to prevent the offender lock-in. That is in the mission and statement of this program. And for the goal, the project goals, we have three in total. This project is still in the process of brewing. It has not taken shape. These are the three major objectives. These are the basic objectives. One is to be open. That is the essence of the open source software community. So the program is open to all the users and vendors. We should prevent the vendor lock-in. All the codes and the programs are open and visible. Also, we hope it's real. For the projects, usually we have the brainstorming and assumptions, but for this procedure or the program, we hope that it can resolve the real problems and pain points. For example, the cross cloud management and the edge computing systems issue and then the data management issue. And another objective is that it's ready for use. It's ready. That means the storage system of client can be a hybrid solution, can be from different hardware and software vendors. And I really like making comparison for the network. The vendors used to say that the concept of coupling or decoupling hardware, software, and the applications should be decoupled. They are from different vendors. Hardware can be from OEM, software can be, or the platform of a software can be the Red Hat or different vendors' infrastructures, and the infrastructure or the function. NF functions can be also different telecoms. So these are the three-layer decoupling. And for the storage, we should also have the decoupling model. The storage systems in the future, you can use ARMs and Intel and ARMs system, and the software can be SAF and other storage systems. So different systems can be integrated and compatible to provide the users with a good solution. Sometimes there is a legacy issue, and sometimes it's because of budget, but the ultimate goal is to integrate all these systems in a compatible way. And for the what is the deliverable? One of the deliverables is the platform itself. At the level of control, it's OpenSDS, and the plugins are from different vendors. They should be integrated into the platform. And another deliverable is a set of standards or criteria, because different vendors take part in the community, so we should have a set of standards and then the certification to see whether you are qualified for that. If you meet that, if you get certified, and then if there is a third party or new entrant, then there is no issue in terms of communication and the data management. So these are the deliverables. Also, we want to build up a community with under the Linux Foundation. It can be participated by developers, operators, users, and the trainers. So these are the four deliverables. So we hope we can achieve the deliverables to users from the SODA project. So far, the major participants in the ecosystem, we already have Intel, IBM, Fujitsu, and Huawei. They are the key vendors in the SODA ecosystem, and also WDHPE, they are also the vendors in the ecosystem. You can see the full list of the participants in the SODA program. And The second principle or objective is to really resolve the pain points of customers.
So we actively connect with those manufacturers to see what's their demand. For example, we connect with the KBM from Europe and also Yahoo Japan. The representatives of Yahoo Japan also come here today, and also Toyota. In China, we have connection with China Unicom. They will feedback their demand in this community. And China Unicom also signed the agreement to become a member of the as the end user. We also connect with the ICBC or other main banks, and we are in the process of negotiation. And there are also two big operators, for example, like Telecom and Telemobile. We are negotiating with them. We believe that we have found a cloud service provider like JD.com who are very interested in this project. They also provide their technology with us, hoping that the SODA can connect to their CFS system. About benefits of membership, for example, you can have financial supports, and you will have suggestions and guidance on how to drive the project. And there are some tailored development for projects, and those projects will be turned into open source, like the Teleunicorn. They have some projects. They want to make it open source, but they don't have the needed resources, so they want users to use their system. So with such a platform targeted at storage, we will be able to help them to promote their technology and products, because many users using these products are inside the community. We have MME Fabric. It is a technology of Intel. We want to promote it. That's why we actively participate in the community, because we found the Yahoo Japan. They are the CSP from Japan. They're interested in this, so probably we can work in the future to see how MME Fabric probably can help them somehow in the future. So by joining this community, you'll be able to promote your own projects. New members or third parties will all get opportunities to promote their own products. And we're going to provide a recognition to the company, like telling you that you are the active user in the community, because we believe they want to improve their influence in the community, especially the storage community. Thirdly, we will also help them design some strategies to build some strategies, like how to operate, how to run the whole project. Fourthly, there is a joint POC, which is very important. We have new technologies, new open source projects. How can we get in touch with our users? Another example is that CFS also want to be used by more users, so they want to use our platform to promote their product. The fifth is that you will be able to grow with the community. Even though the community looks small now, if more storage providers can join the community, then we will see a more prosperous future in the future. Starting from 2016, the community has been growing, and now in 2019, we are releasing the third version. and we are welcoming more users. And we believe that the projects belongs to certain companies can grow together with the community. By joining SODA, there will be some expectations from members and users. They want to participate in a technical project. They want to advocate for the project and want to make contributions to the upstream projects. It is not limited to SDS community and also the EEG and other projects. All of them, we can call it as an umbrella. We hope that from the perspective of user, we want to see some feedback, whether there's new challenges, whether we need to improve. And if we fix the problems, we hope that these can reach our Toyota, can reach Yahoo Japan, and get more feedback. So this is the expectation for members and users. And about the governance model, I want to talk about the blue parts. So I want to talk about the purple card first. It is the new part. OC is the outreach community. I was in the China community, so they selected me as the contact point. So I will get in touch with the large operators, banks, and all kind of CSP to promote it. And also not included here, we have community for North America, for Europe, for South America, etc., and also for Japan. We have many members. The yellow part is the end user, because we have the community of end user. For large projects, we get feedback from them. So that the challenges, etc., can be provided inside the community, then the contributors can help them solve the problems. For the green part is the TSC. Technical Steering Committee. Intel also have members in TSC, if I remember correctly. IBM, Huawei, and Fujitsu, they all have representatives in TSC joining the discussion for specific projects like Papa Sushi or CFS or EEG, all kinds of different projects. We have the PTL, the leader responsible for projects. So this is the governance model we proposed. We hope to achieve such a model. In Chinese community, half a year ago, the community was established and we have set up regular meeting. So in every 2 weeks, in the afternoon of Tuesday, we'll have a meeting starting at 3 o'clock. TSC also have a meeting for every week. Our community was just established half a year ago. We already have many new members joining us in the discussion. And we will also organizing meetups in last October in Shenzhen, in Shanghai, so that we can hear from them. So we will take advantage of the Chinese community to organize different activities, promote different projects. Last but not least, we hope SODA can be put under Linux Foundation and can make contribution in a way of the fees of membership and also the engineering resources. There will be two levels of membership, include premium and general. For end users, government entities, or non-profit organizations, they can join for free as associate members. They might not properly provide codes, but offering feedbacks. So briefly, that's the end of my speech. So I will put it here. So if you are interested in our community or Soda, or if you have any product related to storage, you can contact us via the information here. Probably we can do things together and make some achievements. Thank you.